Cocaine, killers and rock and roll, ex-inmates detail life in the craziest jail on earth. The jailhouse became notorious for its bizarre system of self-governance, requiring that inmates pay an entry fee and purchase their own cells. During an exclusive chat with Daily Star Online, McFadden and Young recalled the surreal scene during one of the most important dates on the calendar at San Pedro, Prisoner's Day. "It's open party," Young explained. "The police don't go in there and the inmates just do whatever the hell they want. They get rock bands in there, they get cases of beer and alcohol. They're openly taking drugs, smoking marijuana. The kids are in there, the dogs are racing around. It is so surreal." While all this is going on, they've got fates, like a big stall cooking food. It's just a big party. It's an annual event every September 24th, and they go all night. Prisoners even share shifts as volunteer peacekeepers to maintain order inside the strange facility, as guards and governors operate a hands-off policy to let inmates decide their own fate. McFadden, a former drug trafficker, was sent to San Pedro after being caught smuggling 5 kilograms cocaine across the border in the spine of his suitcase. It was inside the jail, during his 4.5-year stay, that he met author Rusty Young. In order to make a living, McFadden bribed guards and fellow inmates to allow tourists to visit the prison, offering guided walks around the jail. Young, hearing about McFadden's enterprising business, participated in one of the tours, becoming instantly acquainted with the British convict. He spent the following 4 months as a voluntary inmate, helping write a detailed account of McFadden's time inside the prison that became the basis for Marching Powder. With Young's help, McFadden was released early from his sentence after the pair paid a huge bribe to a Bolivian judge. The pair then fled across the border to Colombia before managing to make it out of South America. Thomas McFadden and Rusty Young spoke to Daily Star Online at the premiere of Wildlands, a companion feature documentary to Tom Clancy's Ghost Recon Wildlands, exploring real-life stories behind the war on drugs. The film is due to be released on March 6.